I have a feeling there are quite a few people in this house today that are saying, that's all great. I'll pour my love on him at his feet. But I don't feel like it right now. I'm going through some stuff. And I haven't gotten the answers. You know, it's interesting. There's so many times in the Bible mentions be still. And we don't like that. Be still. Be still also means wait. And sometimes we tend to be so focused on what we want at the end of the wait that we forget what God's doing in the middle of the wait. And I don't know what you're going through today, but when you pour your love on him, because listen, we're all here because of him. Bottom line, if not one more thing was ever done for us, he's already done it all. So when you say you're going to pour your love, I want you to picture, if you can, this is an incredible week of hope, incredible week of hope. But I want you to picture Jesus standing here. And I don't know what you're going through, and I don't know what you're upset about, or I don't know what you wish you had an answer for. But the bottom line is, it says, if you'll pour your praise and your love on him, if you'll pour your praise and your love on him, picture him pouring your praise and love over his feet. Thank you, Jesus, for in the middle of my wait, I will be still. I will hear you. I will receive from you. I will not complain. I will praise, and I will pour it at your feet. It doesn't make sense, but it does make sense. Give it to him. Love him. You know, we were singing the song and it says, my devotion. How many times have you been devoted to something or someone and it's disappointed you? You've given it all. The good news is you're going to give it all to him and you will never be disappointed. You will always be lifted when you devote and pour your love and praise on him. Let me sing that again.